bring about the harmony, we need to go to ourselves. How can we go to ourselves? It is through meditation. During that period of meditation or thinking of God or repetition of your mantra, no other vibrations affect you. You are only with the positive vibration, higher vibration or godly vibration, godly love. So it brings about the needed harmony. So when you finish your prayer and meditation, you are a harmonious person. So suppose your child comes and asks you, Papa, give me this. All right, I give you. Now I am busy, I'll give you later. Or someone else comes, says, this is my problem. Well, if you have no time, you may say, all right, I will handle the problem, please give me a little time. So you keep up the contact, there is no cut with the person. Same thing, whether you are on the road, the problem is there, it's natural, you have to face the problem. When you come to the workplace, yes, colleagues are there, there are friendly colleagues, there are colleagues who are not jealous of us, who create problems, ambitious colleagues, and all that and all that. It's normal. It is their problem, don't worry. Why should you get into their problems? You be what you are. You do whatever you can do sincerely, with all love. So that brings what is called the better result. So with that, one is able to progress. So you are not cut off from the colleagues or from the workplace. It's a good relationship. In you there is harmony. Wherever you go, there is harmony. You are not affected. So this is what we want. In our everyday life, without which we will not be able to face the problems. Problems will be there always, everywhere, in every field of our life. One holy person is not free from the problems. Take for example, Ramakrishna himself, was he free from problems? How many people used to come and insult him? Was he angry because he was a holy person? So, it is that inner harmony that expresses itself as the dynamism, inner dynamism. So it is that inner dynamism that keeps us what we are. You say, oh my God. So your mind becomes God, God consciousness. The same word God, you turn it dog. How suddenly the consciousness drops. So in the same way, what you call the repetition of the mantra, it is the higher vibration which helps to elevate the consciousness. So take for example, when we say Om, what happens to us? Our whole being vibrates with that vibration. See, the consciousness automatically raised up. All other forces are eliminated. In the same way, what you call the repetition of the mantra or japa or whatever it is, it goes on raising your consciousness. And that vibration becomes intensified in your personality. So all that contacts limits you get eliminated or alienated. So more and more purity, more and more takes place. So you become that. That is why thou art that, tattvamasi. Also, when that consciousness becomes that consciousness itself, you are that. Prajnanam Brahma. The direct knowledge, consciousness, or infinite consciousness is infinity, Brahma. So we should not separate this what we say God and ourself. The jnani or the realized soul says aham brahmasmi. I am Brahman. But the body-bound man should not say so. It is harmful to him to say, I am Brahman. Because we live in the body, we are conscious of the body, we feel the body, so that is why Ramakrishna says, we should not deceive ourselves by saying, I am Brahmasmi. You may question, Swami, we sang Brahmahamasmi, Sohamasmi.
For some of the guidance.
We can sing it. We can try to bring about that consciousness that is needed for.
And that's the provision.
Yeah. So otherwise, simply if you say, I am Brahma, aham brahmasmi, are you really Brahman? They take, for example, in our meditation method, we say, it's all automatic. You are not to feel your body at all. Even if you feel body, it is connected to the infinity. Take, for example, visualize yourself, visualize the infinity as blue space. Well, your consciousness gets into that aspect of the infinity. Then, feel that this infinity is the harmony of pure energy itself. It is possible because the forces that exist in the universe are nothing but the expression of infinite energy. And it is this energy that expresses itself in every cell and molecule of our body. See, the consciousness is directed to the infinity.
It's different than saying I'm Brahmasmi.
Yes. And then all other aspects, luminosity, beauty, love, intelligence, knowledge, bliss. So gradually you are made to intensify these aspects. So when this becomes intensified, the consciousness becomes that. Now if you say that I am so and so, it is our consciousness that has made us feel that I am so and so. Is it not? The same consciousness is directed to the infinity. Every day you say, you connect yourself to the infinity. You may question whether there is no body consciousness. Yes, there is body consciousness also. But then, this consciousness also is connected to the infinity. I say, infinity expresses itself as Om. As I explained, explained this morning, every cell and molecule of our body vibrates as Om only. So touch your upper and lower lips and feel the vibration of Om has a significance. It is through the mouth that we express. It is through the mouth that your intense love is expressed. And also I say, touch your organ of speech and feel the expression of infinite pure consciousness. That is Om. I see the consciousness rests not in the organ of the speech, but in that vibration of consciousness. So it is this that expresses itself as your speech. So here, egoism is not there, ego consciousness is there. So this consciousness is connected to the infinity. The same way, space, it is the harmony of pure energy itself. It manifests itself as pure air for us. You may call it oxygen, call it by any name, but it is part. So, I say, now touch your nostrils. Touching means, in one way, this body consciousness is directed to the pure consciousness. Touch your nostrils, repeat Om mentally, and make activate the nostrils. Means that vibration goes on vibrating. The consciousness is connected to Om. So, it activates your two canals, Ida and Pingala. Then breathe in this pure energy. So, your consciousness is with the pure energy. Our consciousness becomes pure energy itself. Retain it, feel it in every cell and molecule of your body. So, the body consciousness is not totally eliminated, but it is there, but it is transformed as the pure energy. Feel every cell and molecule of your body as pure energy itself. Then breathe out. So, we are not disturbing any of our physical system. Simply you are transforming your way of functioning. So breathe out good thoughts and pure love. You may ask, why not breathe out impurities? No. It has two reasons. One reason is that if you breathe out impurities, where it will go? It will vibrate in the atmosphere. Either it will come back to you or affect someone else. We want that to be that way. So let the impurities or imperfections be there. Don't worry about it. Now, bring about good thoughts and pure love. Spread it in all directions. Means it is something like a safety wall around you. See, if you create pure love, it is pure love that reflects. Good thoughts that reflect. So it is a kind of what is called safety wall that is created by us. In the puja method also, take for example, the worshipper at one stage has to spread sprinkle water around and feel that he is protected by a fire of wall of fire. here, instead of fire, we are creating a wall of pure love and good thoughts. So the good thoughts and pure love goes on vibrating all around us. The next stage comes, see, our sense organs. See, vision. General tendency of the eyes or ears or other senses are to go outward. Now, we make it to go inward. See, inner vision is most important to see ourselves and the reality. I see, visualize the rising sun, because our whole physique is converted solastic energy converted as physique, is it not? So there is connection. So you visualize the sun and be inside the globe of the sun and feel that you are yourself is the rising sun, full of luminosity and beauty. And you may say it's all imagination. No, it's not imagination, but it is truth. I can tell you a story a little later. Real story. Visualize rising sun and feel that you are yourself the rising sun. Touch your eyes, try to intensify your inner vision and feel that every cell and molecule of your body is shining like the red rays of the sun. Now, you see, why sun? In the Upanishads is mentioned Aditya. In the Vedas also, that name comes Aditya, Surya, sun. It is not necessarily this physical sun, it may be spiritual sun or whatever it is. So it can be the hibiscus red color or golden. In the Vedas and Upanishads, both are prescribed. Both colors are prescribed. So, you have to feel that every cell and molecule of your body is shining like the rays of the sun, red rays of the sun or golden rays of the sun. So, you see, your vision goes inward. And it is this harmony that expresses itself as Om. Touch your right and left ears. See, the body is there. Body consciousness is transformed as the infinite harmony. So touch your right and left ears and feel that every cell and molecule of your body is expressing itself as Om only, which is infinite harmony. Then, it is this infinite harmony that is pure consciousness. You touch your entire body, say to yourself that every cell and molecule of your body is pure consciousness itself. So what happens? The eye consciousness gets connected to the infinite pure consciousness. So then, it is this pure consciousness that is pure love. Place your palm on your heart. See, again, the body is not neglected. Place your palm on your heart, because the heart is the seat of all emotions. To feel that pure love, feel that pure love in every cell and molecule of your body. So, automatically, when you touch here, you feel a soothing effect, is it not? Even in ordinary acts, we say, oh my. So instead of saying, oh my, om I. Om I becomes infinite, pure love itself. Here we have not eliminated anything. It's all inclusive. So you feel the pure love.
This is a new this is a new thing.
New method.
New
discovery.
See, I do this meditation along with Christian nuns and monks. They don't feel strange with it. They like it. Once in 3 months, I go to a Christian monastery. It leads us to the goal. Because it is based on the reality. Now, for the yogis also, this heart center is important. See, it is a center connection between the lower chakras and higher chakras. So, here the pure love should be felt, and it must be made manifest in every cell and molecule of your body. Why I say that is that, you see, your emotion is expressed how? Is it from the heart or the head? We say it is the heart, but in reality every cell and molecule reacts to it. Take for example, when you get angry, you know what happens? the feeling of anger comes. From where it comes, it may say it comes like this, then goes like this. Now, unless every cell and molecule of your body reacts that way, it cannot rise up. So the blood becomes heated up, face becomes red, and confusion starts. So it is why this pure love should be intensified. Every cell and molecule of your body is pure love only. Now this love should not be confused to what is called mundane love. Love of objects, love of sense pleasure, this and that. No. It is pure love. It cannot be objectified. Well, it is this pure love that is pure intelligence. You must be knowing that Ramakrishna saying that pure love and pure intelligence are one and the same. So pure buddhi and knowledge are one and the same. So you take the palm to the head. So body is not forgotten. It is there, but it's converted. The real conversion is brought about. So one has to feel every cell and molecule of one's body. It is pure love itself, pure intelligence itself, knowledge itself, bliss itself. See, the totality of everything is brought about. Well, now one more aspect is there. Courage. How do you define courage?
Yes.
It is not the physical force. It is not a mere intellectual force. It is the combination of all these forces. force of pure love, force of pure intelligence, force of knowledge. Energy is there already. So all put together becomes the courage. You may question, to show our courage we have to have that strong physical force, not necessarily. I give you the example of Ramakrishna yesterday. Was it a physical force that fell dead the dacoits? The other day Dayatman was mentioning about the Gauri Pandit who was chanting, was it Hara Hara? Something like some mantra or something like that. Ramakrishna started chanting louder than the Pandit. Louder and louder. From where he gets this force? A weak person. From where he got that force? It is in force that expresses itself. So what is called courage? Courage is the harmony of all these forces that expresses itself as courage. Now, body is the expression of that of those forces, and now it is reconnected to those forces of reality. Instead of seeing I am the body, I am this, I am that, you are seeing tattvamasi. So here in this method or technique, no question of personal God or religion or nothing comes up. We are totally with the reality. So that is why our Christian monks or nuns appreciate it. All these impurities or negative forces, they lose their power. But go on pouring the mind, positive thoughts, until it becomes positive. And what happens? The red paint doesn't remain as red paint. It takes different color altogether. Automatically, these forces, they get their power reduced. But they are not totally, destroyed. It is there. The element is there. It gets destroyed only when you attend to samadhi. It is only in that state it is possible to reduce it to the state of what is called dhagdabhiya avastha. If you burn a seed, it has no power to sprout. Maybe that it may be there, but it has no power at all. You see, you have an ink pot. Of course, nowadays we don't use ink pot. For many years, you have not used that ink pot. The ink that was there has become dried and has become so very thick. In the same way, all the impressions have become so very thick inside. Now, one fine day, you want to clean it up. Use the bottle for something else. You have to go on pouring pure water, go on cleaning. All the ink water comes out. So in one day you may not be able to do it. It may take several days for you to clean it up. For us it may take several months or years to clean up. So ultimately what remains? Clean pot. In the same way, all those impressions, past impressions, they are washed off. Here pure water means positive thoughts. for example, Swami Vivekananda himself, who would not believe in the existence of God, who would not worship any images, and all that. By mere touch of Ramakrishna got transformed. That power, Ramakrishna is nothing but the expression of infinite power and force. Yesterday I was giving the significance of Ramakrishna. Rama, that is the power to burn, power to purify all the impurities of everyone. Krishna is the power of attraction. So that power attacks. So you see, the touch of Ramakrishna eliminated all other aspects, doubts, removed all the doubts, was totally absorbed. And he never left Ramakrishna. And the result you see. So this is the power of infinite reality. It has the power to change anyone, everyone, provided one gets connected to it.